What is going on, guys? It's your boy Usaid, and I'm back here with another video. Right now, I'm at the gym, guys. I just got here. It's about like 6 a.m., and I'm about to go through a leg routine or leg workout. And this leg workout is gonna be more focused on posterior chain and hamstrings. Something that isn't my, I guess you could say, strongest point, but it's not really my weakest either. Something I'm always trying to work on, something I'm always trying to hammer on, just because when you have a strong posterior chain, your performance as a strength athlete, as any kind of athlete, whether it's field, strength, you name it, man, posterior chain is super, super important. And your posterior chain involves your glutes, your hamstring, and your lower back erectors. So I'm really gonna hammer that today, and I thought I'd just take you guys through my workout, show you guys some of the things I do in order to really improve on those points. And yeah, I feel like when I get my hamstring stronger and my posterior chain stronger, my deadlift, my squat, end up getting stronger and improve a lot better and help for injury prevention. So yeah, I'm gonna take you guys through my workout. I'm gonna start off with box squats. Box squats are a great movement for explosiveness and can help you with your other lifts as well. It'll help with overloading and stuff like that. I typically do it off kind of a high box and just to really help with my explosiveness. So yeah, I'm about to warm up and get into it. Hi guys, right now I'm just warming up. So what I'm doing with the box squats is I'm gonna work up to a heavy single, and then after I hit the heavy single, I'm gonna do 80% of that single for 5 sets of 3. So the purpose of why I'm working up to heavy single is I'm trying to work up to a heavy set, get that heavy set out the way, and then for my back down sets, I can get more reps in. And that way I'm getting kind of the best of both worlds. So work up to a heavy single and do some back off sets. Let's get it. All right guys, this is my top set. 400 something, man, I don't even know. But it's my top set, let's get it. Come on! This is my shit! Oh! All right, that wasn't too bad of a top single. Kind of looks shaky getting it out because I think I put the rack pins too high, man. So when I was taking it off, it was kind of hard to kind of stabilize myself, but it wasn't too bad, it wasn't too bad. So now I'm gonna do my back off sets, 5 sets of 3. After I did my back off sets, now I'm doing a different variation of the box squat. I'm doing 30% of the top set I just hit today, and I'm doing it off a lower box, and I added chains on the bar. And the reason being is I'm doing that just to help with more explosiveness, and with the weight being a lot lighter, I can really focus on just exploding and working on my speed, right? Hold up, let me take off my belt. Ugh. All right, now I didn't talk about this earlier, I should have, but I'm using a safety squat bar. I'm doing that because the safety squat bar really works on your upper back, and it's not the most, I guess you could say, stable position on your back, so you really have to work on stabilization with this bar. But you know, if you don't have a safety squat bar at your gym, don't worry, you can use a regular bar. It's, you know, obviously you're gonna be missing on some upper back work, but that's okay, just use a regular bar, that's fine. Now I'm supersetting this with hamstring curls, and I'm gonna do 3 sets. I'm doing 4 reps with the box squats, and then I'm gonna do a different variation on the hamstring curls. I'm gonna show you guys. All right, guys, so now with the hamstring curls, I'm gonna throw a little twist on it. If you guys ever heard of 21s, probably heard about doing them with bicep curls. Well, you can do them on the hamstring curls as well. So pretty much what I'm doing is I'm doing 7 reps halfway up, and then I'm gonna do 7 reps from the top position all the way to halfway, and then I'm gonna do 7 full reps. So in total, that's 21 reps. And the purpose of why I'm doing this is I really wanna fill my hamstrings with blood and really get a really solid pump in my hamstrings, and this is a really good way to do it, so I'll show you guys real quick. So you want to keep the weight relatively light because you're not really focusing on how much weight you can push. You're really focusing on contraction and filling your hamstrings with blood. All right, guys. The next superset I'm doing is I'm supersetting leg press with Bulgarian split squats. Now with the leg press, I'm making my feet wider, and that's really going to hit my hamstrings and my glutes a little bit better. It's still gonna hit my quads, but the more I kind of widen my feet out, the more it'll hit my hamstrings and my glutes. Now the other thing I'm focusing on while I'm doing the leg press is I'm focusing on pressing through my feet as if I'm kind of deadlifting or squatting, because I want the leg press to transfer over to my other lift. So I'm really focusing on pressing through my feet. And then I'm gonna show you guys how I'm doing Bulgarian split squats. Why? My feet kind of pointed out. And then 10 reps. Boom! Boom! Oh. All right, guys. Now I'm supersetting this with Bulgarian split squats. I'm using a weighted vest. You don't have to use a weighted vest. You can use dumbbells, a barbell, it doesn't matter. But lunges are really good for hitting your hamstrings and glutes. Every time I hit my legs, I incorporate some kind of lunging movement, whether it's walking lunges, reverse lunges, doesn't matter. I incorporate something, because the thing about lunges is now you're kind of unilaterally working your legs. So now you're working on each leg separately, and that also helps with imbalances, which is something I struggle with too as well. So, and the thing with Bulgarian split squats is now there's kind of a stability factor involved into it. So that's really gonna translate over to whatever it may be, deadlifting or squatting, because in those kind of big movements, there is some stability factor required to it. So I'm gonna hit 10 reps on each leg. Guys, last superset. I'm supersetting seated hamstring curls with JHR, I think that's what they're called, JHR extensions. And I'm gonna show you guys real quick. Now, with the hamstring curls, I'm going for 3 sets of 20 reps. And with the extensions, I'm doing 12 reps. So the reason I'm going super high reps on these curls is there's no actually padding for you to kind of rest your knees on. So I'm just really focusing on the contraction and trying to push as much blood into it again. So I'm gonna show you guys real quick. All right, 20 reps. Really focusing on the contraction. Alright guys, so with these extensions, let's say you don't have this piece of equipment in your gym, you can use a normal back extension and it still applies, it still hits your lower back and hamstrings. Now I'm using a dumbbell to add more weight and more resistance. And with this, I'm really focusing on pulling through my hips when I'm coming up. So that way it's kind of mimicking the top portion of deadlifts. When you're coming up in a deadlift, when you're locking out the weight, you really want to focus on exploding through your hips. And this movement will absolutely do that. So I'm going for 12 reps here. And that's actually a weak point for me in my deadlift is usually my hips. I have soft knees when I lock out, so really focusing on pushing through my hips and my glutes. And in turn, it's also gonna hit my erectors a bit, so let's do it. Let's go for 12 to 10 reps. You know what I'm saying? So get the dumbbell, and then just squeeze. Boom! Alright guys, that was the workout. I finished off with some abs. I didn't really record all of it because I didn't want to make the video too long. So yeah, I know guys, that wasn't really a really long workout, but I think it was pretty effective. I think I got what I needed from it. And yeah, I usually do a lot more volume, guys, a lot more sets and reps. But you know, as of lately, I've been kind of crunched on time. So I tried making my workouts efficient as possible and not try to carry out too long. The whole workout lasted, I think it lasted like an hour and a half. That's because I was recording at the same time. I think it would have lasted probably like max if I really pushed it an hour. So let me know what you guys think of the video. Let me know if you guys like this kind of routine or even like this kind of type of video. If you like me talking and explaining why I do things and my workouts and stuff like that. So as always, guys, please like, comment, share, subscribe. Show your boy some love, man, and take care.